structure. About the dimensions, our Minisumo has an area of 10 cm in the base and a weight of 5 kg. For the project, we couldn't reach the official measures like in a national or international tournament because the peak and the components were bigger than we expected in a first impression. So we did it a little bit out of official rules. It was made of wood with some parts of metal because we wanted it to look aggressive. Materials. The materials used in our robot were the big 16F877A, which is like the brain of the robot because inside of it are all programming which controls it. The Bluetooth module. It allowed us to control the robot with our phones in an app which we made specifically for this project. The line sensor. It is very important while it fights because no matter what, if he touches the edge line, the robot will go ahead or will make the action required for don't let get down of the ring. The edge bridge. It allows the DC motors to run forwards or backwards. The motors, which were focused all the power to hit and destroy enemy robots. The boost converter. It steps up voltage while step down current from its input supply to its output load. And finally, two lithium batteries of 3.7 volts because we didn't want to run out of energy.
Now we want to describe the process that had to be followed to finish our goal. The most important thing for us was everything we learned about the programming language and the logic. We had some knowledge but not necessary to start the project. For this reason, the time was too short. While learning things like the handling of signals, noise interruption, or serial communication, that was important to the transfer of data. This can happen in two ways. They are serial communication and parallel communication. We use serial communication, which is a technique used to send data bit by bit using a transmitter and a receiver. Finally, for the motors, we use a pulse width modulation. A common way we use them is to control the direction of a servo motor. This allows us to vary how much time the signal is high in analog fashion. While the signal can only be high, usually 5 volts, or low ground at any time, we can change the proportion of a time the signal is high compared to when it's low over a constant time interval. Our case will use 100% duty cycle, and the digital signal spends all the times in high state. So, the first time that we want to try the PSB, there is red blow up. Of course, we don't keep in mind that the elevator was delivering more than 12 volts and in our series component is no fault. This means that we had to stop all the project and immediately we called a contact to solve that. However, we had to present the advance only with legs that simulate the motors and the directions. Once the circuit was adjusted, we created the application in App Inventor. In general, the application works by the Bluetooth model. Serial communication and functions RC were programmed, such as forward, back, right, left, and diagonal direction. To me, this was the best part I never worked with Bluetooth before. I know it's more effective to use a joystick, but it's more complex and time didn't help. In the future, we will do it.
How we said before, we know that the infrared sensor is a dispositive that emits an infrared light, detecting the quantity of light reflected. By this way, it is able to differentiate between white and black, many kinds of sensor we can find, for example, like the TV control and many others. We use a digital sensor. This means that when the signal is 1, but if the signal is black, the number is 0. At the moment, when we were going to the code for only radio control, the robot worked pretty well. He followed all the orders that we sent him. 2. When we only did the infrared part, the robot worked so well. When he detected the white line, he changed the direction, how we plan. But when we mix the radio control part and the sensors, we find a problem too. We try many and many ways for fix it. Even though the different codes they worked alone, when we compiled them together, they weren't working. We saw the code and we found the trouble. The key to make the code was the heavy hit. We use it and then they worked. After that, the next step was put the code into the big 16F877A and then the robot could detect the lines with the sensors. The second and last problem was put the PCB into the robot. When we did that, the robot wasn't running, not even the LED shined. The Bluetooth module and motors wasn't working either. After many time trying everything, we used move one capacitor, and that there was the problem. Even though we didn't have many time, we set it with silicone to the capacitor stayed still. When we fixed the trouble, they were missing only 5 minutes to compete. When we arrived there, we could pass the round and the round until the final. We lost the final, but we were too happy, because before that we had nothing and we could have everything. We were so proud about our work.
Conclusion. This robot was a proof that we are really getting better in a lot of aspects, not only in programming, also in teamwork and effort. This project includes all the teams stipulated in the subject digital electronic 2 in a smart way, because it was really funny and productive, because the best strategy to learn is while the students enjoy. A lot of things cause us setbacks, for example, the edge bridge running out all the time, check the correct operation of the PCB, choose the best wheels, make it look powerful and that stuff, but with help we could fix it. This project caused healthy competitiveness, which all of us were winners. Just so I can flex, take the app at the mall.